you know, I took my hat off and he was like, you know, what'd you do? What'd you do? I was like,
I'm getting into character.
This is my character. I feel this is my character. Yeah. It's like, and he panicked.
There is no bigger, no more iconic movie star in the world than Tom Cruise. Controversial, wildly successful, he has lived his life in public pretty much since he was a teenager. But there is one thing you realise when you sit down talking to him. He has been obsessed since he was a kid with the big screen and where it could take him around the world. His latest film, American Made, is the true story of an airline pilot entangled by the CIA, drug cartels, and indeed the White House itself in South American Revolutionary Wars of the 70s and 80s.
Oh, this is legal?
If you're doing it for the good guys.
This is Tom Cruise and the movies that made him.
Yeah.
All right, Tom Cruise, lovely to meet you. Thanks so much for talking
to us. Nice meeting you,
So I want to talk about American Made, but before we get there, can I ask, of all the different films that you've made, what was the one that changed you the most? What was the one that had a profoundly different Tom that went into it that came out the other side?
You know, the first film I made, Taps, because I wanted to make movies my whole life, and to have that opportunity and to start out, I went to every single department, studied every aspect of filmmaking.
In honor of this auspicious occasion, Major Moreland, your presence is requested in the hallway.
It was a very formative and unique experience for me because, of course, I'd never been on a movie set really. I had just one day with Endless Love, but I was learning all about cameras and lighting, and you know, I go and also script and how movies are made. At George C. Scott, Sean Penn, and you had Harold Becker who directed it, and we'd spent over a month preparing the film. They had brought us all down as young actors. I was 18. And
wow. That's an incredible acceleration in your career from, like, I mean, a few years out of high school to suddenly doing that.
Not even a few years, it was months. It was months.
Jeez, I'd give my right nut for those Oakleys.
But I remember there was a day that I showed up where, in the morning, I thought, you know, my character, I want a shaved head. So I went into town, I just shaved my head, and I showed up to Harold, you know, Mr. Becker. And I said, you know, Mr. Becker, you know, I took my hat off, and he was like, you know, what'd you do? What'd you do? I was like, what do you mean? You know,
I'm getting into character.
This is my character. I feel this is my character. Yeah. Like, and he panicked. And for about an hour, he was really panicked.
It was a big mistake, Brian, if you don't want me saying so.
And he was going to try to, you know, should I get a wig? You know, what's happening? And then he realized, he's like, no, this actually worked. This worked. And then he really was very generous with me and would bring me in. And, you know, we used to have a thing called rushes, and every day we'd look at the films from the day before. And it was a real privilege to be invited in to see the rushes, and actors generally weren't, especially young actors. But he knew of my interest in film, and he basically cut together edits of scenes, not just of my scenes, but of other actors, so that I could watch and just really kind of say, these are the takes that are going to be in the movie. And so, you know, I was lucky. People were very generous with me.
Those early days, I've heard you say, those early days between, you know, right up until you're hitting Top Gun and stuff like that, you said you felt a lot of pressure in your career. I'm wondering, what did you mean by that?
You know, there was a very steep learning curve for me, as you said. I was a couple of months out of, you know, but I've seen a lot of films, but I'd never made films. And I mean, you always feel pressure. I put pressure on myself. I'm very demanding on myself.
I feel the need for speed.
I was always working as a kid. I always had jobs, you know, and even since I was 8 years old, I was working. So I just had a different viewpoint of life, I think. And I realize that now, you know, in looking at it in terms of goals. I had goals in terms of what I wanted to accomplish.
What was the goals that you had in your head at that point?
I wanted to make movies. I wanted to make movies and do it for the rest of my life. You know, as a kid, I never really went to the same school more than a year and a half. You know, I was someone who really, you know, wanted to have an adventure and do extreme things. You know, I was climb trees in the middle of the, you know, and the wind is blowing, and I used to write skits as a kid.
Really?
Yeah, and entertain my family and.
Because your mum was in amateur theater, wasn't she?
Yeah, but that for me it was more. I was just naturally drawn to that. She never taught me anything.
Yeah, right.
No, she never did that. And it was, but it was something that I would just write skits and create characters.
And the winner is Tom Cruise, Magnolia.
Can I ask you about one of my favourite performances of yours, which is Magnolia? Because it's just the most visceral thing. And I think for a lot of people, it was one of those things that we hadn't seen you do before. A lot of actors talk about drawing things from personal experiences, but I understand you don't like doing that. So where do you pull from?
It's not that I don't like doing that, it's that I don't find it necessary. You look at a child who's there and he's got a most amazing imagination, you know, children. You're just looking at them and they can create, become different characters instantly. That's just how I develop characters. You just kind of feel it there and you just start working on a character and I find something that I feel is interesting and I just start playing with it.
I will not apologize for who I am. I will not apologize for what I need. I will not apologize for what I want.
But, you know, if you look at Magnolia, I mean, that's a character that I basically, it was very different in the script. The opening lines that I ended up doing, and I remember I had PTA was there, and he kind of was having me in khakis and Adidas. I was like, I said, no, that's not this guy, you know, just, and I didn't see him. So what I did was, is I basically wrote the opening monologue.
Respect the cock. And tame the cunt.
And I have a screening room and, you know, a different workshop where I work on characters and movies. And I lit it exactly as,
you know. This is the stage?
Literally built a stage in my screening room. And I said, look, I don't know how, sometimes because words are something, you know, you could talk to them, people don't understand. I actually like just doing it. You know, I don't like talking about things too much. It's like I get little things and then let's do it. Let's start creating it and see it, you know. And I remember I just went on stage and I did basically the opening monologue for him. I said, look, I don't know how to, here's the character.
I am the one who's in charge.
And so I did the whole opening character. When you see him, that opening, that's what I did for him. I had the music there, I lit it just to explain that character. And so sometimes you just start doing it. And a lot of that stuff I was writing and working with him and ad-libbing a lot of that stuff.
When did you realize that was the best way that you knew how to work? That was what was going to work for you?
You know, instinctually, that's just how I always worked. Sometimes what I'll do is I'll come up with a character and then I'll put it into a movie and I'll rewrite the whole script based on that. I mean, Edge of Tomorrow is a film that I made where a couple years before I was kind of just thinking about this character and thinking about a style of film I want to do, and basically I rewrote the script from page one and put that whole idea in there. I'm constantly, you know, I'm usually shooting a movie while I'm prepping a couple of movies. I'm in post on a couple of films. Like right now, I'm you know, I was released The Mummy and I'm shooting Mission and I'm a post on American Made and I'm prepping.
Jeez, mate, you need to do more in your time. Come on.
Aerostart, we are ordering you to land immediately.
I want to talk about American Made.
Sure.
So there's a weird like existential sadness I felt in the first 15 minutes where Maverick from Top Gun was like this beleaguered TWA pilot. Something very, very sad about that. And I was wondering, are you aware of the iconography that you bring to every role? Is it something that factors in into a production?
Definitely, you know, I don't think about that.
Really?
No. If you look at the kinds of films and the wide variety of films that I've made, it's wanting to challenge myself in every kind of genre, in drama or comedy. Satire is something that when you look at American Made is satire.
Yeah, very black.
Based on a true story. This guy who's found himself is almost like Huckleberry Finn, finding himself in the center of epic moments in our history.
You never saw me.
He was a great pilot. He was a great aviator, you know, and Doug Liman and I, you know, we did Edge of Tomorrow together and we're working on this one, and Doug's a pilot and I'm a pilot, so all the flying that people see in it, that's...
Is that really you?
Every part of that is me flying.
How big is the insurance bill on you?
You know what? I don't even look.
Why is it important to do that stuff physically?
Well, you look at it. You're not going to get that footage in any other kind of film. you don't get shots like that, you know? And we had to camp out there to get the shots that we got. We were in Colombia, basically had to carry the fuel with us. And Doug and I, you know, we had tents set up and we slept out there to just get the, it was guerrilla filmmaking. We, you know, when we were making it, and every day, the three of us, you know, we were writing the script every day. Me, Doug, and the writer lived in the house together while we were creating this story.
Is it scary to embark upon a production knowing that you're going to make changes throughout, or are you comforted by that flexibility?
That's movies. You start with the script as an idea, and it has to be treated as such, and you have to constantly find and create your film. And I want to make great films, and I want to make them and entertain these audience. And I really task everyone and put their feet to the fire with, like, this is it. And every day is, means something. So, and you have to be able to move quickly. You have to have people around you and high level, talented, skillful people around you too, so that you can shift and move in the way that you need to move. And also admit when something isn't working and go and try to figure out how to make it work and not just accept defeat. You know, for me, when I'm making a film, I only get one chance to make it. That's it. So it's not just as simple as, here's the script, let's go shoot the script. That's just very much the beginning.
Tom Cruise, I could literally talk to you about this movie forever. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, man.